Los Angeles, California, following a hot tip from my friend Yaro about a company called Tribogenics.
They discovered a way to generate x-rays by peeling a piece of scotch tape. And from there, they're building a company that could transform the world of x-rays. And boy, oh boy, did I have fun meeting some of the characters at Tribogenics.
We're creating products that have never been created before. X-rays in the palm of your hand. This is the future of x-ray technology. This is Tribogenics.
The crazy thing we discovered is that you can make x-rays by peeling scotch tape. Basically, we were getting about 50 kilovolts, 50,000 volts, from 100 micron separation in about 2 nanoseconds. So the energy density is ridiculous.
This is cool. This is like one part engineering firm, one part scientific research lab, one part machine shop, and then, of course, it's all underneath the umbrella of a business.
And I've always wanted to see technology go from the bench at the lab, like really new technology, like this is really cool, this is the first time that anybody does this or sees this, into a product or make a difference in someone's life because it has a positive impact somehow. What if you had an x-ray capability in every first aid kit to do some quick triage, or that you could send wirelessly to some facility to tell you, okay, there is a fracture that needs to be immobilized?
I was still a little fuzzy on how they went from scotch tape to a miniaturized x-ray source. So I asked Eli to explain the science for me.
What we've got here is we have this device in which we fundamentally, in a certain sense, don't understand how it works. The literature always focuses on these charge buildups and how much charge is built up and how they build up, which is interesting. But no one focuses on the discharge. For us, we need to know it because we need to understand how to be able to most effectively generate x-rays. So right here is the basic equation that tells us how many electrons leave the surface at a function of time. We take that equation, we plug it into the model to simulate the device. And then we test the actual device and measure critical parameters. We take those parameters and plug them back into our model.
What do you think? Can you imagine how miniaturized x-rays might be used? Let us know in the comments. Subscribe and stay on our radar.
The Bremsstrahlung is literally called braking radiation. So as it's slowing down, it's the radiation that's emitted by the electron as it's slowing down, and it makes a spectrum because it doesn't slow down instantaneously. It takes time.